having got to know the information about the analysis of a random variable, which is in turn obtained by summing up two independent random variables, we shall have a look over some of the example or exercise problems on it. So what is given in the question is that x is a random variable having an exponential distribution with the PDF given as fx of x, which is taking up a value as lambda times e power minus lambda x for x being greater than or equal to 0 and 0 for x being less than 0. So what is our job is we'll have to find w, which is represented as the sum of two independent observations of x. So here my w will take up a form as x1 plus x2. So our job is to find out the PDF of w. So what is that you will have to do here? The PDF is given to you and it is in turn stated that w is taken as sum of two independent observations of the same random variable. So my job is to make sure that to obtain the PDF of w, I'll have to convolve fx of x with itself. I'll have to convolve fx of x with itself in order to obtain the PDF for w. So I have just written the formula over here, which represents the convolution between fx1 of x and fx2 of w minus x. So what you can observe in this formula, fx1 of x is representing what? The PDF taken at the time instant x1. So what is this? It is fx2, which represents the PDF of the random variable x taken at the instant x2. But what you can observe within the parenthesis, I have something like w minus x. If I take this w to be 0, then what do I get? Fx2 of minus x. So what is that representing? It is basically representing you the reflection operation or the folding operation. If you have a look over this particular topic in terms of your signals and system analysis. So if I fold a signal about 0, we call that folded signal as the reflected version of the original signal. So if I take up this w as 0, I get something called as fx2 of minus x, which we usually call as a reflected version of fx2 of x. So what you can observe here is that what are the operations that are involved here? First thing is, one of the PDF is kept fixed, whereas what happens with the other PDF? It is getting folded or it is getting reflected. Then what is the other thing that is happening here? I have something like w minus x. If it was just minus x, it is folding or reflection. If I have w minus x, which means what? The folded version is getting shifted. So what is the amount of shift that is getting introduced? It is by w units. It is by w units. So what you can observe here is that if you have to perform convolution of two signals or two PDFs, so what you need to do is one of the PDF would be kept fixed, whereas the other PDF would be folded and then it would be shifted by w units. And then the common overlap region will be obtained and in turn it gets evaluated over the limits, over the region of integration. So now, having got to know like what has to be done, I've just plotted my first PDF. So what is that PDF that is given? It is fx1 of x is lambda times e power minus lambda x, which is already given in the question. And in turn, it is said that this PDF is valid only for x being greater than or equal to 0 and 0 for x less than 0. So if you have a look over this particular plot, below 0, I don't have any value. Above 0, I have the value which is represented by an exponentially decaying curve, whereas the peak value is represented as lambda. At 0, the value is lambda. And after that, as you keep increasing, as you keep proceeding, like moving towards the time axis, you can see that the value of the curve keeps on decreasing. So I can call this as an exponentially decaying function. So now what I have to do is I'll have to make use of this curve to obtain the PDF of the random variable w, which is taking up the sum of this PDF with itself. So what is my second job? I'll have to define fx2. So what is the first operation that I have to do? I'll have to make sure that fx2 is getting folded above the origin. So if I fold this curve about the origin, whatever curve I have on the right hand side could now be represented towards the left hand side. So this represents my fx2 of minus x. So if you observe here, the right hand side I have 0. So original it was left hand side was 0, right hand side I had an exponentially decaying curve. Now if you observe fx2 of minus x, you can see that right hand side will be 0, left hand side you'll have an exponentially decaying curve. So they are mirror images of each other. Okay, now what is the next operation that I have to do? I'll have to make sure that this fx2 of minus x is getting shifted by w unit. So now observe this. If I shift this curve fx2 of minus x towards the left hand side, how do I represent the shifting operation? It is minus w minus x. So I'll have the notation as fx2 of minus w minus x. So if you keep moving this towards the left hand side, you can see that right hand side it is 0. 0 into anything is 0. So now what we can observe from this is that for any value of shift w taken to be less than 0, the value of the integral gets reduced to be 0, because I don't have any value of this, any positive value or any value in the right hand side of this curve. So what you can observe here is that when this fx2 of minus x is getting shifted towards the left by minus w units, in essence w units, what happens is that the product of these two PDFs will be 0. So when this 0 gets evaluated over the integral, obviously it is going to be the 0. The result is going to be 0. So now what I can write is that for w less than 0, my value of the PDF is 0, as there is no overlap between fx1 of x and fx2 of x. Similarly, we have analyzed this curve being shifted towards left side. So now we'll see what happens if this curve is getting shifted towards right side. If I take w to be somewhere here at this point, so which I've represented somewhere here. See, if I take off fx2 of w minus x, wherein w, I've just shifted this by w units. Now my w is somewhere here. So now if you have a look over these two curves, this is my fx1 of x. This is my shifted version of fx2 of w minus x, by where w represents the amount of shift that is getting introduced towards the right. So now if you observe this, these two curves above 0, 0 to w, this curve is having some value. Whereas this curve has a value, non-zero value from 0 to infinity. So if you multiply these two curves, you'll have a non-zero value only between 0 to w. Beyond w, once again the curve, like the product of the two curves is 0. So how do I evaluate this particular curve now? My region of integration will be only the region where the two curves will overlap with each other. So my region of integration will be only from 0 to w. So I'll have to evaluate these two PDFs from between 0 to w. That is what is gonna be done here. For w greater than or equal to 0, I'll have the PDF of w being evaluated only from 0 to w. So I'll write up the definition fx of x1, wherein fx1 of x was given as what? Lambda times e power minus lambda x. Next I had fx2 of w minus x. So I'll replace x by w minus x dx. Now I'll separate out the terms, and upon integration I'll take up lambda into lambda outside. So I'll have lambda square. This I'll have the form e power minus lambda omega into e power lambda x, wherein e power lambda x minus lambda omega can be taken outside because the integration is only with respect to x. So upon reduction, this is of the form e power a into e power minus a, which gets reduced to 1. Upon integrating, we'll be having w being evaluated over 0 to w, which gives us the value as w. So the final PDF that we are getting is something like lambda square w e power minus w for the value of w being greater than or equal to 0. So collectively, if I write my PDF, I'll have an answer something like this. If w of w will be equal to 0 for omega for w less than 0, and lambda square w e power minus lambda w for w being greater than or equal to 0. So if you relate this to the concept of signals and systems, as you are already aware of, a unit step function is defined as a is defined to have a value of 1 for x being greater than or equal to 0. If I have the unit step function being represented as u of x, this u of x will have a value as 1 for x being greater than or equal to 0. Then, making use of the definition of unit step function, I can write the first PDF, that is fx1 of x, as lambda times e power minus lambda x, x greater than or equal to 0. This condition, x greater than or equal to 0, can be replaced by u of x, because u of x is having a value as 1 for x being greater than or equal to 0, which means from 0 to infinity it will have a value as 1. So anything multiplied by 1 gives us the same thing. Similarly, the PDF of w can also be written in terms of unit step function, which is nothing but fw of w is equal to lambda square w e power minus lambda w into u of w. Hope you followed the first example. We'll have a look over the second example, wherein what we are doing is we are going to convolve two rectangular functions or two rectangular pulses. So always remember, before you could start off with the mathematical computation of these two rectangular pulses, always remember, whenever you convolve two rectangular pulses, you come across a triangular pulse or a triangular function. So end of the day, when you are done with this solution, the solution has to represent a triangular waveform. Okay, so we'll start off with the second example. Second example, the question is something like this. The random variable x is given to you, which is having a uniform distribution between plus or minus 1. Then once again, two independent realizations of x are added to obtain a new random variable, which is represented as y in this case, whereas in the previous example, it was w. So y is given as x1 plus x2. So now our job is to find out what is the PDF of this y. So before we start off with the simplification, you should be aware of the standard PDF of a uniformly distributed random variable, which is given as 1 by b minus a, wherein x would lie between b to a. So here the range is between minus 1 to plus 1. So the PDF of the random variable would be 1 by one minus of minus 1 will be 1 by 2. So if you plot this, you'll have a rectangular pulse having an amplitude as 1 by 2 lying between minus 1 to plus 1. So now, once again, I'll have to perform convolution between these two rectangular pulses, wherein both the pulses are the same. So what is my first job in order to perform convolution? I'll have to make sure that the first PDF is kept fixed, whereas the second PDF will be folded about the point zero, and in turn, it will be shifted by W units, right? So here in this case, it is by Y units because W is replaced by Y. So I have shifted here fx2 of minus x. So you can observe here is that I get the same function here. So always remember, any rectangular function, when you perform reflection or folding operation, you get the same result. That's the reason we say that a rectangular function will always satisfy the property of symmetry. Rectangular function will always satisfy the property of symmetry. Now, I'll have to shift the second PDF, which is being folded by, which is being folded about zero by some y units, right? So I'll have the PDF being represented as fx2 of y minus x. So now what I do is I'll take off some arbitrary point y towards the left side. We'll see what happens if the value is less than zero or greater than zero. I'll have to remember what would be the range. The other thing that you need to remember here is that before we proceed with the further simplification, check with this, the first PDF is having a range from minus 1 to plus 1. Similarly, the second PDF, the original one, is having a range from minus 1 to plus 1. If you sum up the right hand side range, it will be 1 plus 1. Similarly, if you sum up the left hand side range, it is minus 1 to minus 1. So your output signal, in a sense, the final result will have a value between spreading from minus 2 to plus 2, minus 2 to plus 2. So always remember, whenever you are doing convolution, the two ranges would get added up, and that would be the result of the convolved output range. So now what I do is I'll have a look over the shifted version of fx2, wherein the shift is getting introduced with the reflected version by y unit. So I'll take off some y in the left hand side. So this becomes my y, but my actual signal is between what? Minus 1 to plus 1. So if I have to map this signal to my shifted version, this y would have towards the right hand side being represented as y plus 1, whereas the left hand side I'll have the range as y minus 1. So if you have a look, the width is once again 2 units. How do you get to know the width? Upper limit minus lower limit. So you'll have y plus 1 minus of y minus 1. If you take up the difference between these two, you'll get the value as once again 2 units. 1 unit towards this, 1 unit towards this. So now, as I've already told, whenever you are convolving two signals, the resulting signal will have a range or spectral spread, which is represented by adding the range of the two signals which are getting convolved. So here I have the spectral spread of each signal between minus 1 to plus 1. So my resulting signal will have a spectral spread from minus 2 to plus 2. So beyond minus 2, you should be aware of that. That the value of the function is going to be 0. And beyond plus 2, the value of the function is going to be 0. Only it will have a non-zero value between minus 2 to plus 2. So now, having written this shifted version of fx2 of y minus x, wherein y represents the amount of shift that is being introduced, I'll evaluate my convolution integral over the range minus 2 to 0 first. So why is this the range being taken as minus 2 to 0? As I've already stated, my signal would have a spectral spread from minus 2 to plus 2. But the shifted version of the signal has a spread of 2 units. So whenever I evaluate my convolution integral, I make sure that my variable would be evaluated over a span of 2 units. So here, if I take up the range like minus 4, it has to be between minus 4 to minus 2. Similarly, next it has to be between minus 2 to 0. Then it has to be between 0 to 2. Then if you want to further evaluate, it has to be 2 to 4. So I'll be moving in steps of 2 units because the shifted version of the signal is having a step size of 2 units. Okay. So now what I do is, the first signal I'll have to keep it fixed, the first PDF. The second PDF I'll have to shift it, right? So I have the generalized version of fx2 of y minus x, which is getting shifted by y units. Now I'm saying that my second PDF is lying in the range of minus 2 to 0. So I'll make sure that this upper edge is occupying a value somewhere between the 0 and minus 2. I've taken that value at this point. So this point becomes my t plus 1. So obviously y minus 1, please change the variable here. I've taken it to be t. Kindly change it to y. Okay, this has to be y plus 1. This has to be y minus 1. So if you have a look here, my y plus 1, I've taken it somewhere between 0 and minus 1, whereas here lies my y minus 1. It is just this curve has been placed at this point, okay, wherein the range is taken to be minus 2 to 0. Now if you take up the product of these two curves, you can see that fx2 of y minus x is having a value as 0 beyond 0. So when you multiply this range of the curve 0 and 1 with this particular range, the product is going to be 0. Right hand side, the function, like the product of these two PDFs is 0. Whereas when you have a look over the left hand side, what you can observe is that fx1 of x is having a non-zero value between minus 1 to plus 1. In a sense, minus 1 to 0. So now if you observe here, fx2 of y minus x is having a non-zero value between minus 1 to t plus 1. So now my job is to evaluate this particular region of the curve. So now I'll take up the generalized formula. This is the only region that is getting overlapped. That's the reason it is shaded here. So this is the only region that is getting overlapped with my fx1 of x. So I'll have to just integrate this region, the product. So here the value of the PDF is 1/2. Likewise, even here the value of the PDF is 1/2 because it is stated that fx1 of x is uniformly distributed between minus 1 to plus 1. So the PDF was 1/2. So 1 by 2 here, 1 by 2 here. So here fx1 of x1, this would be fx2 of y minus x, which is once again taking up the value as 1 by 2. So what happens to the range? One here you can observe that the shaded region represents the region of overlap. So what are the limits here? It is between minus 1 to t plus 1. So my product would get evaluated over that this particular range. So it is between minus 1 to t plus 1. Upon integration, you get the result as t plus 2 by 4. T plus 2 by 4. Similarly, next I'll have to evaluate the integral over 0 to 2. Why? In steps of 2 units, because my shifted version of the signal is having span of 2 units. So now, next case is between 0 to 2. I'll take off the same curve, fx2 of y minus x. I'll shift this between 0 to 2. If I shift this, the lower portion comes and sits at t minus 1, and this is 1. So the upper end goes beyond 2. So now if you observe this, the common region of overlap is between t minus 1 to 1. So you'll have to integrate between t minus 1 to plus 1. So the value of the first PDF is 1 by 2. Value of the second PDF is 1 by 2. Upon integration, you get the result as 2 minus t by 4. So this would be the PDF of your y between minus 2 to plus 2. So if you want, you can even verify the result from 2 to 4, you'll get the value as 0. Similarly, if you evaluate between minus 4 to minus 2, you will have to get the PDF as 0. So have a look over the next example and try this as a part of your homework. So I've taken x to be one random variable uniformly distributed between 0 to 3. So what would be the PDF? It is 1 by 3. Next, z is another random variable which is independent of x and uniformly distributed between 1 and minus 1. So what would be the PDF of z? It is 1 by 2 between minus 1 to plus 1. So your job is to find out the PDF of u, which is in turn given as x plus z. So first sketch of the PDF of z, which is represented by a uniformly distributed random variable between 1 and minus 1. So I'll have the PDF. So the value of this curve between 1 and minus 1 is 1 by 2. Similarly, the random variable x is having a uniform distribution between 0 and 3. So I'll have the representation. So the value of this PDF is 1 by 3. So what I need to do is, one of the PDF you'll have to keep fixed, whereas the other you'll have to first fold it and then keep shifting. So here, from looking at this solution, you can easily say that what would be the range of the PDF of u. So I'll have to add up these range. 1 plus 0 is 1. This has to be minus 1. Please change this. This has to be plus 1. So minus 1 plus 0 is minus 1. So next it is 1 plus 3 is 4. So f u of u will have a non-zero value between minus 1 to 4. Minus 1 to 4. Less than minus 1, the value of the PDF has to be 0. And beyond 4, the value of the PDF has to be 0.